bring me out. It's the word that brought me out. And the word will bring you out too, but some of y'all don't want to be out. Some of us don't want to be out. Some of us want to go straight to hell from church. No matter what you preach, what you teach, what you show, what example you show, some people just destined to go to hell. It ain't got to go. They just going to go. That's a choice. He said, I set before you life and death, blessing and curse. He said, I set before you. Now you choose. So if anybody go to hell, it's a choice you made. Anybody. So you don't have to go even today. You ain't got to go. And God don't need your riches. God don't need your money. He needs your soul, body, and spirit. That's what he needs. But I know he ain't go deep enough for you. Let me just give you something. You can certainly hold your breath and live in sin, but for how long? You can do it, but how long? And some of us just walk around in sin and ain't trying to get out at all. For how long? They always putting on sin. Stop sinning. And if you were living right, you wouldn't worry about them preaching on sin. Because you said, tell them, preach to them. But since you're in sin, you had to sit here like you were sucked on a lemon. And I don't want you to be comfortable here. I want your little nasty self to always know I'm in your business. Sinner. Hebrews, the fourth chapter. And I don't have an anger problem. I'm a contender for the faith. Not a pretender. I'm a champion for God. In other words, I don't mind saying it. I'm his MVP. I'm his most valuable preacher. And still, I'm still preaching hell about him right now. And still, I feel pretty good in my old sanctified soul. No, they say I'm a fine brimstone preacher, so let's get this party started. Hebrews, the fourth chapter, beginning at the ninth verse. There remaining, therefore, a rest to the people of God. See, it's a rest for the people of God. And all y'all ain't got no rest, you know why you ain't got no rest. It's a rest for the people of God. And that what it said, it's about he that is entered into his rest, he also ceased from his own work. You got to put your work up. You got to put your stuff up, y'all. We still trying to do what we want to do. It said, there is rest for God, people. But that's what I love about him. He put this stuff right here in the book, and we so blind, we won't even go look at it. For he that is entered into his rest, he also has ceased from his own work, as God did from him. Let us labor therefore to enter into that rest, lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. Oh, Heavenly Father in Jesus, Lord, have your way in this service. Do whatever you desire to do, God, but have free course. God, I'm so glad your spirit is in this place, the word of God. And God, we just say, have your way, God, have your way. Lord, you feeding us well in this place. And anybody want to suffer malnutrition, that's their choice, God. Because you have spread the table in this place. God, we just have your way, God. Do whatever you want to do, God, but have free course. Because you said if you be lifted up on the earth, you'll draw all men unto me. God, we come to look at the name that's above every name. In that name is Jesus. Holy Ghost, do what you do. In your son Jesus' name we pray. And every heart can say amen, amen, and you can have your seat. You know, my wife and a lot of us in here work at the industrial center. And I don't have an upper and a lower. And when the upper and the lower, they stick a tube down your throat. Another tube go up your, y'all ain't got to be scared to say it. The tube go up your butt, y'all scared to say it. So the word of God is like in doctor center. They got a tube that go down you, and they got a tube that'll go up you. The word of God is like a probing instrument. And I had a brother text me and tell me, Pastor, you got to keep preaching because you're going crash where don't nobody else go. He said, it's like a probing instrument. So when I said the ways of sin is death, I'm getting in your business. When I said shacking is wrong, when I said smoking is wrong, I'm in your business. But God got a magnet on. See, y'all didn't know that was down there. But God got a way of finding stuff that you don't know nothing about. And that's why y'all be getting mad when God be preaching. Y'all be getting mad talking about, why he always in my business? How did he know that? Y'all got a lot of hidden sin in him. But God tell the apostle, you got to preach it and find where is that. Come here, boy, stand up. Let me run that probe on you. See where you got sin at. Oh. It's going to be kind of tight for me to get it there. But I can get up in here and probe and see where he got sin at. And some of y'all so slick in here, y'all know how to hide it. It didn't even come back to you. It won't even let you get away. It probe and come back to you. It don't let you just think you all right. But I know how some of us, we think because we by ourselves, we think because we do it at night, we think don't nobody know. But with that probe, put a light on it. He'll put a little light on it. He'll put a little light on you. And that's why people don't like Cornerstone, because he will put a light on you. And the magnet still works. So all the stuff y'all think y'all got here, that's why y'all come here and be so looking so crazy. Because y'all only think God see you, but he see you with your little nasty attitude. You ain't never happy about him. It don't matter what he do, you still got issues and problems. But it's your issues and problems because you don't want to let it go. Said so let it go. It looked like another TKO. Y'all can see this all hidden up here. Y'all didn't see how I figured that out? God still be shining on y'all. And y'all think y'all got to hear. God be telling you, I see you. And instead of you just getting rid of it, you still want to, oh, it look like a little bigger there. Oh, it don't matter. It don't matter. God pick it up all. All of us got our problem and keep wanting to do what we want to do and think don't nobody see it. God said, I'm shining a light on Ted. I'm still shining. Every time they come to the church, I'm shining on them, trying to tell them. He said, but look, Ted, I ain't pressing who I go up in. I go up in the preacher too. I probe him too. I search him too. And that's what they're wrong. That's why we want to find a church that don't probe. We're going to find a church that don't tell you the truth. Because you want to go to hell not knowing you're going. God don't want you going there not knowing you're going. You try to act like you was on the straight road. You try to act like you were with me. You try to act like you was on the narrow road because you came in here and sung like me. You came in here and talked like me, but you was an enemy to the cross all the time. A lot of y'all still going to the club. A lot of y'all still smoking. A lot of y'all still drinking. A lot of y'all still listening to BLS and hoochie coochie and woochie boochie. All that. Putting filth in your ear. It's that, you know, that's wrong. That's wrong when you know better. That's wrong when you know better. But you think you're all right. You think you're good. And God was so good to me, my other thing didn't work. So he went and hooked me up with a red and black. Got you bad, God. And put silver on in. Ain't God good? It don't matter what you get. You can get in the pulpit. He'll pick up your seat. Ain't God good? And we sit here, even though he shows we wrong, we still try to stay in sin. That's the crazy thing. He said, not only I probe and go places you ain't want me to go, I also got a light. Ain't that something? Just start looking around. That's what that word be doing. It says, search me, Lord. If you find anything, but I find anything, you can't say nothing, can you? See, when the word get close to you, you can't say nothing. I know y'all ain't understand. Search me. So when you find anything that shouldn't be, he said, take it out. In Matthew 10:34, I'm going to preach. He said, think not that I come to send peace on earth. See, everybody think God has come to send peace on earth. He said, think not that I come to send peace on the earth. He said, I came not to send peace, but a sword. What you mean a sword, Pat? What you mean a sword? He said, in Ephesians 6:17, it said a sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Luke 18:11 said, now the parable of this, the seed is the word of God. He's telling you it's the word of God. Most people tell you sow a seed, they talking about money. But God said it was the word of God. And now we don't want that seed sold. The word of God is a proven. I can give you an up and a lower right now. And I ain't looking for cancer. I'm looking for sin. Yeah, I don't want to go to that church. They getting your business too much. That's what it come to do. He didn't come to bring peace. He come to bring a sword. Y'all try to get away. Now, y'all had that one kind of up in there. But I ain't need no light to see. I just need the Holy Ghost. It draws sin. It's a proven instrument. He said in Hebrews 3:7, he said, wherefore, as the Holy Ghost said, today if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart as the day of prophecy. He said, now don't harden your heart, because I done told you, I already been proven. You ain't just got started getting probed today. You've been getting probed the whole time. But you still want to stay in sin. Tell where you going, baby. Probing ain't get you, did it? Oh, come on, Tyre. Oh, the Lord don't toll on you. Oh, God. He said, set about this very day. Because tomorrow might be too late. He said, the day that you hear my voice, don't keep trying to get away from me. He said, do not shut your ear and harden against such a voice as this. The hardness of your heart is the spring of all other sin. When you start hardening your heart against God, it brings in all other sin. He said, on my time will I follow God. See, we want to tell, I'm going to follow God when I want to. But God said, Terry, I'm probing them all the time. And they want to serve me when they want to. But I ain't die when they want to. I ain't die when they wanted me to. I died when my father told me I had to die. He said, wherefore was I grieved with this generation? I'm God, we're grieved with this generation. God agreed with the people in the world of 2016. He grieved with church and not. They won't preach the truth. They letting people sit in church and go to hell straight from church, and we sitting here getting the word and going to hell straight from him, even though you're getting the word. Just a bunch of rebellious people. This is what he said. He said, wherefore I will grieve with this generation and say, they do always err in their heart. He said, they might not err in their doing so much, but they're erring in their heart. You know, if it's in your heart, it's where you're treasure is and where your heart is. See, when you where your treasure is, your heart is somewhere, that's where you go. If you like the club, you're going to go to the club because that's where your heart is. If you like the freak, you're going to go where the freaking at. If you like dope, you're going to go where the dope at. If you like God, no, I can't say that because everybody go to church now. I can't say that. I'm going to say that's where your heart at, but that ain't where your heart at. He said, they have not known my way. He said, so I swear in my wrath, they shall not enter in my wrath. He said, I swore in my wrath. And everybody trying to tell you everybody going to heaven, but you can't put nothing before God. And people think they can serve God how they want to, when they want to. God got a standard. Look at it right now. Jesus sitting at the right hand of the Father, waiting for the dad to give him permission to come back to earth. He's sitting there just waiting. Obedient. Can't do nothing without God. He said, everything I do what my Father say. And now we want to do what we want to do and don't care about God. And some of us don't care if we go to hell or not. Because we don't really believe it's a hell. But baby, it's hot, eternal, low, and lonely. You can act like you don't believe. Well, what makes you come to church? You got to believe something. He said, while it was said, today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart on the day of provocation. Then the 19th verse of Hebrews 19:3, it says, so we see that they could not enter in because of unbelief. Pastor, you don't understand. No, it's unbelief. I looked at him and said, unbelief. At the root of all rebellion is willful disobedience of is unbelief. He said, this simple refuse to trust in the Lord and his word. You refuse to trust in the Lord and his word. It don't matter what it said. You can God we can preach hope all you want. You ain't believing it. You ain't trusting in it, so you ain't got hope. The word of God is a probing. Ooh, can I get a upper? Could I get a lower? Can you check me out? Can you see where I'm at? You can't hide. He always such. And that's why you sit and hear me saying, who told? Why he got to come with that message today? You did something the other day. He just wants you to know. I got you. How many of y'all here in this business? How many of y'all here in your business this morning? You can act like you don't. Well, you can sit up and act innocent. I know you're in your business. I see how you're looking. He said, they shall not have rest. He said, God is grieved only when his people sin against him and continue to sin. Sin shut up the heart of God and shut up the gates of heaven against you. Sin do. It don't matter what you say. You can let these preachers fool you. You're going to heaven. You is not going to heaven with sin. Amen. That when I be preaching, I just be spinning that pro around. That's why people don't let me preach too much. They say, that nigga, no law. Oh, ain't no move too quick now. You, hey, you kind of got like you were trying to get away from me now. Hold up, sister. Hold up. You all right? Beep. Beep. Be walking. Why I be preaching? I ain't come back over that tire. I ain't coming back. You don't want me coming over there, dude. Don't tell my kid now. Because that's what the word do. You start talking back to the word. Word come on back over that. Now you ain't saying nothing. You ain't saying nothing. The light on too. What's up? Now I ain't hearing you that bad now. God reading you now. You know it's gonna come back to me, like when the doctor's doing the up and the lower, the doctor be seeing. You know they got a light in there too, right? You know he's talking to me, though. What you think he's telling me? You think he's good enough to tell me what you doing, what you've been doing? You think he can tell? You feel like he already telling me no. I don't know, he already told me. One thing about it, what'd you think? What'd that be? You want me to get it? I don't know, it might turn into a snake now, I don't know. I ain't coming there. No, you ain't said that, you just said, Lord, help him. Do not send him over this way. Cause don't do it. You see how God do it? In Romans 1:18, it said, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodly. That's what God said, all ungodly. Huh? He said, all ungodly and unrighteous are men who hold the truth and unrighteous. That's what we're doing now in 2016. We hold the truth and unrighteous. We letting anything go. And I told the church the other day, I said, y'all know it's strange. I want y'all to listen to me. No one never thought that same-sex marriage would happen. I didn't think so. They got me. I didn't think we'd have a black president. I didn't think so. But I want to ask y'all something. If all these churches not having Bible study and Sunday school, and they having small group, where they putting anybody to teach a small group, so we got all these churches split out. If we don't teach the children, where the church gonna be in 5 years? Just like a dinosaur. We knew dinosaur was living, but now we don't have. We knew dinosaur was there. But what we used to think that it wouldn't be a same-sex marriage, it is. We didn't think we'd have a black president. Now we're finna have a woman. Them things we didn't think would happen. But where the church gonna be in 5 years? Where it gonna be? Because if we ain't teaching the children, where it gonna be? We gonna be sitting up on a chair in a museum. They gonna say, this how the church used to be. This how they used to preach. This where the church used to be. This where they used to reverend preachers. Now, preachers can be gay and people still go to church. You know why? Because they took the word out the church. It don't mean that no more. In Matthew 13:23, it said, but he that received the seed into good ground is he that hears the word and understand it. See, most people sitting in church don't understand. Right. So that's why the preachers don't go to the simple stuff. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And they can't tell the truth because the trustees or the deacons will get rid of them. Right. But when you preach the truth, it might leave the church empty like this.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, most people don't want to go to the storefront, but God gave us an eloquent a sanctuary, and people still won't come because they say, "Nah, man, I like the way Terry preach, man. He be telling, but man, you know, I heard one dude came in and heard me preach. He said, man, Terry preach good. He just in too much people business. So I guess that cut that out. But look what it said, but he that received the seed into good ground is he that hears the word and understand it, which also bear fruit and bring forth some hundredfold, some 60, some 30. Now they'll tell you that's money. But God was talking about increasing knowledge of him. See what I'm talking about? See, so I mess them up, I'll take their offering down. Because I let them know they weren't talking about you getting no hundredfold. They were talking about a hundredfold and you increasing. So here I come. I'm in the preaching program. I'm up here butt now. I'm up here butt. I'm trying to, let me turn the light on your butt. You ain't had no business telling them people that lie. I'm all up your butt, preacher. Because you lying to God, people. You scamming God, people. And you talking about he wants you to give a 100-fold, a 60-fold, a 30-fold. God was talking about increasing in his word. And they can't increase in the word because you won't preach the truth. So I'm telling on you. They'll say you're probing, man. You getting in other churches' business. That's my job. I'm going to give you what the word say. And the word said, oh, Lord, get them possible. I don't want my light to go out on y'all because y'all think y'all can get away. This is what God said in Luke 9 and 23. He said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself. So already now, if you ain't denied yourself, I'm probing. Have you denied yourself? That's what we need to stop for a few minutes. Let's pause right there. Put your car in pause. Don't. Pause. Have you denied yourself? So that already let them know. We ain't going into the rest. Because we don't believe God wants to deny himself. He said, and take up your cross daily. You don't just take it up on Sunday like we do. We come and tired like we. That way you taking a cross. You just tired because you ain't did nothing all week. I've been going through all week. It wasn't for the Lord. Now you might have been smoking dope, drinking 2-11, having unlawful sex, walking around butt naked, scraping and everything like that. You might have did all that, but you ain't did nothing for the Lord. Who did something for the Lord yesterday? I don't told y'all about putting them hands up. Lord, please don't let him come over here. That's the only time we pray. Now we pray in church. When I'm preaching, it'd be some praying going on. Lord, that man crazy. He'll say anything. You know I'm gonna say it, sister. How'd he get that thing? Where'd that come from?
That's probing.
When they picked that up?
Picking up all that wrong.
Lord, I ain't even picked that up. How'd he get this? Lord, I'm trying to see what it do like Moses did. I'm trying to see if I get it turned into a snake. I know y'all don't believe it, but if it turns into a snake, one thing gonna be gone, it gonna be possible. If it turns, now I wanted to turn into a snake, but I'm gonna be gone though. I'm just gonna be up. Oh, I got you. You were up in the crop up there. Right now, say I'll go up in them cracks and get you. Some of y'all ain't laugh. I guess it ain't funny. But it's just the way God do you though. He just set you up. I love him too. He said, let us labor therefore to enter in to that rest. Lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. The word of God is quicker and powerful. He said, it's quicker and powerful. How powerful is a tear? It's powerful enough to pull down strongholds. We talking about the word of God. Huh? It's powerful enough to raise the dead. It's powerful enough to make the deaf man hear. It's powerful enough to make the blind man see. The dumb man speak. The lame walk. It's powerful enough, huh, to battle against Satan's attack. It's powerful enough. We're talking about the word of God. And we ought to be glad it's proven. We ought to be glad it's in our business. We ought to say, God, get in my business. I don't care what nobody want to probe. Probe me, Lord. Get me. Get anywhere you want to get. Probe me. I don't care where you go, God. Just take up, get everywhere. Get me, God. But see, we don't want him to probe. We don't want him to tell us where we're wrong at. We don't want him to tell us. We just want to keep going to church and act like it. We want to act like we saved. And we ain't studying God. When we get to him, we got some of the nasty disposition, nasty attitude, and we don't know how to love nothing. Just heard the other day, build you a foundation in faith, Build you a wall up, a house of God, a Christian house, and put the roof of love on it. We ain't do that. We're a different monster at home. Coming in here, God, hearing God press the word and still stay the same. You know that's just a disobedient person. Just wrong, just bad. I don't care what they say. I'm going to do it like I want to. Will probe me to examine. Will probe to investigate thoroughly. To make a critical investigation. Critical. Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. That's how you're going to get sanctified. You can dip in water all you want. If water would have did, all have been saved, unless you ain't bathing. You know, because we got some watch the face Christians. You know y'all women ain't got no business just watching y'all face. Now me and Mike can get away with that a couple of days, but y'all women, it's bad to be smelling like Simon. I'm serious. It's a bad thing, you know. You know, I'm just trying to probe and help y'all, because some of y'all, you know, we need to have, might have some personal hygiene classes. Put the light on, Apostle Sim. Put the light on. You see that one I'm talking about? You hear you talk about that? I told the truth. Amen. You put some fish in the garbage can and leave it in there, your house tore. Now, I ain't lying. Now, some of y'all men like fish. I just ain't one of them. I like them to eat them. I don't like them to smell them. This message is for you, Whitney. Think I need to come on down now? You don't want me to come? No, that ain't what you just said. You said, uh-uh. Now, which one it is? Stop praying now. You want me to come? Everybody saying, you want God? You want to come? Come on, God. Come on. Ain't no use trying. Come on, God, because you might tell me something. I might be finna die next month. I might finna get cancer. You might want to lay hands on me. I don't know why. Trust me. You know? It still work over there. Yeah. Y'all thought because I have it. Y'all thought, Apostle, you can go on over here now. You ain't got it. It still work. God's word still work. If you a sinner, it still work. It don't matter if you in church at home. It don't matter. God got a light on this thing. And boy, I'm telling you. I'm telling you, like Motel 6, we don't need a light on for you. I ain't know how God gonna do the mess, but he's doing pretty good right now. You know, that's what I like about him. He said, look at him. He said, in John 14:7, he said, even the spirit of truth. That's why God tell you how to be born again. It said, whom the world cannot receive. You see that? The world can't receive the spirit of God. That's why they can't receive a man of God. They can't receive a woman of God. They can't receive a prophet of God, because they don't like the spirit of God. It's in the word. And we think we have a church because the choir sing good and the keyboard player good. That ain't church. It said, even the spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive. He said they cannot receive it. Huh? Because it sees him not, neither know him. But he know him, huh? But you know him, for he dwells with you, huh? And shall be in you. That's being born again. That's why I tell you, you must be born again. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. So if you ain't born again, you ain't a new creature in Christ Jesus, and you're still doing the same old thing, he probes you every time you come in here, because he's trying to tell you, I want you new. Probe God, probe. He said, look, in St. John 14:26, he said, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name. He already don't send him. He shall teach you all things and bring all things into your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. that I know Pastor talking about that this God is a probing instrument, but I don't see it like that. Well, turn with me to Proverbs 20 and 27. It said, the spirit of a man is the counsel of the Lord, searching all the inward parts of his belly. That sounds like that probing to me. If he's going to search all the inward part of your belly, and he got to know what's in your heart too now. Huh? So y'all can't tell me. I'm going with the scripture. I just brought this and look at, look at it. And you know my other one had broke. Y'all know the other one I used to have? And you know what God told me? He said, go over there and check your light. So I walked over here when I was studying the message, check my light because it been working. It ain't working. So I said, God, what'd I do? He said, go find another one. And you know to see red and black, I had to get there. I'm serious, y'all. I just love God because he's so good to me. I know y'all probably saying, well, Pastor ain't really getting that bad now. Yes, I am. I'm telling you one thing. God already know where you at. Yeah. Okay. All I got to do is preach. And right now I'm still preaching. I'm making you aware that God knows just where you at. Yeah. You can't fool him. You can't fool him. I love him for that. He said, I must work the work of him that sent me while it's day, the night coming when no man working. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. That's what God trying to say. I am the light of the world. In 1 Corinthians 10 and 12, he said, wherefore let him that think he stand, take heed lest he fall. When you think you already on a ride somewhere, you ain't finna take the biggest fall of your life. And you know, some of us in here, we know right now in this church, Cornerstone, we know we ain't close to God. We know we ain't nowhere where we should be with God. And we hearing all the word. And when you die, God's going to say, he that knows to do right, that choose not to do it, I'm going to beat them. So all y'all tired, let me tell you something, baby. You're going to take a beating. Because God keep talking to you and you keep playing with that fooling. He going to beat you bad, baby. He don't care nothing about you being 19 or 20. He said when you come into the knowledge of truth and you keep playing and he keep telling you, that's why you can't sing that song. You keep getting caught up with stuff in the world and God keep telling you, get away from it. And you keep playing with it. You keep dancing with the devil. One time he's going to spin you around and leave you where you at. We get caught with too much stuff. And that's what God is saying. The word of God is a proven instrument. And you can't pick, tell, I'm going to serve God when I want to. Because God ain't my name, going to take it in. And that way he come back in 1 Corinthians 10:21. He said, you cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of the devil. You can't eat out of both, drink out of both cups. And that's what the church trying to do now. They trying to drink out of their cup on Sunday. And then they trying to drink everything else too. You too. Your grandmama keep praying for you. Your grandmama keep bringing you to church. You got other things on your mind. A whole lot of other things. And you don't think God's serious too because you like the world too. You ain't got to tell me I'm right. I know I'm right. Because you didn't see me the other day, but I seen you. And if you don't watch it, you better watch them little girls you being around too. Because I seen a little girl sleeping on your shoulder. That ain't look good. You know, so much stuff going on. Girl sleeping on your shoulder, that's a question mark. Got a lot of stuff. That's what I'm saying. We let stuff go on. We don't want to change. And then you die. And then you wonder why you end up in hell. You end up in hell because you wasn't studying nothing God said. And God ain't dealing with age. God ain't telling you, well, she 10 and she 4, she 5. If you can work a cell phone like y'all doing, work a computer, you can love God the same way. That's what I'm telling y'all. I ain't making no excuse for these children. Time out. And that's why God said in Isaiah 55:11, he says, so shall my word be that go forth out of my mouth. He said, when it go forth out of my mouth, go forth out of my prophet mouth, go forth out of my evangelist of the mouth. He said, it shall go out and accomplish. Yeah. I ain't got to do what the apostle said. I ain't got to do what he said. No, you ain't got to do it. That's why so many people in hell now, they didn't do what it said. All the people that followed Moses and all of them, a lot of them went in there. ain't nobody in the world or the earth. Because they didn't want to do what it said. Miriam said, do you think God just talked to Moses? She turned white as snow. He said, no, he don't just only talk to Moses, but me and Moses talk mouth to mouth. So whatever y'all want to say about me, me and God talk mouth to mouth. And ain't nothing I don't told none of y'all that God ain't showed you that I was telling the truth. So it don't matter. He said, you cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of the devil. You cannot be partaker of the Lord's table and the devil's table. You cannot do it. The word of God is a proven instrument. He said in St. John 8:47, he said, he that is of God hears God's word. You therefore hears them not, because you are not of God. It's in the word. And people won't preach it because they want to fill it up and get money. But your life is in state. I ain't gonna let nobody send me to hell playing with me, and I know I'm in sin. I know I'm living wrong. I ain't gonna do it. It's bad, y'all. And the church full of that. I keep telling y'all, what gonna happen? In 5 years, I'll be 64 years old. Anytime I can go off the earth. If all the old people here die right now, what these young people gonna do with God? So you know, they getting the word and they go against it. Our young people getting the word and go against it. Good example, Tyra. She getting the word. Got two saved people at home, two parents. She getting the word. She hear the word just like they do every day. But still go against God's word. So my question is, what going to happen to all these big churches right here that the children ain't getting the word of God? What are they going to be? The church is going to be done with. Anything going to go on. You will see stove, like we just seen a church the other day. No, it became a place that's selling refugees food, whatever it is. They were made out of selling food. A church. It closed down. There were a lot of buildings going to be there. They're going to close down. They're going to make them out of something else. And that's going to be mockery of God. Y'all ain't got to listen to me. And that was Proverbs 14:12 said, there's a way that seemed right unto man. But the end of that way is death. It don't matter how you do it. You keep loving this world. Keep loving it. Keep making loopholes. Keep playing to please everybody. Well, I don't do what they do. Everybody going to be talking about me. Shoot, there ain't nothing. Let them talk. It's a critical examination. He said in Romans 13:1-2, he said, let every soul be subject unto the higher power. For there is no power but God. But of God. There is no power but of God. The power that be ordained of God. Whosoever therefore resists the power, resists the ordinance of God. And they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. He said, that's what they're going to receive. It don't matter. I don't care. I'm going to preach God truth. And you can get all the money you want. You get high as you want. And you drive the best car you want. When you die. What? Huh? What? You think about it. You go party and club all day, all night long, get high, get drunk, have sex, and then you die. What? Every message that you don't heard, it's going to come back to you because you're going to be conscious of what's going on. The word is trying to probe you to tell you, get right, church, and let's go home. Don't get on the evening train. Get on the morning train. Get on me right now. And we keep playing with it. He keep reaching out to you. He keep pulling on you. And we keep going, oh, I'm going to get it right after a while. You know, ain't nothing going right for me. Man, ain't nobody got no time for you, a little pity party. When you had it right, when you had stuff going right, you still want to serve God. So that ain't no excuse. Get it right with him now and let him work for you. We don't want to get right. We love sin. We do. It just pour out our flesh. It just what I want. And until the devil get on your track, that's when you think about God. I'm happy where I'm at. And I want to get closer to him. I just want him to take over me. Just take over me. Every thought, every time I wake up, it's just Jesus, 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 Jesus. Just Jesus, 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 Jesus. I'm calling on him, but I might be. He said his name is called the Word of God. And that's so in Revelation 19:15, he said, out of his mouth goes a sharp sword, huh? That with it he should smite the nation. God, I'm tired of this stuff. Everybody want to act like they can do what they want to with me. He shall rule them with a rod of iron. God, I'm tired of them. I'm tired of them. You come back in 2 Timothy 2 and 12 and 13. It said, if we suffer, if we suffer, we shall also reign with him. If we deny him, he will also deny us. If we believe not, yet he abide faithful. He cannot deny himself. He can't go against his word. He can't go. So when he said the ways of sin and death, that's just what he means. You can't change that up with God. No, we're going to do something. When God pick you up and catch you in sin, you can't even get off till he wants you to get off. He just swing you around and let you just keep sinning and keep sinning. Yeah, well, don't nobody know I'm sinning. Baby, God got you on the magnet. Got you already. He already know what you're doing. Your daddy might not know. Your mama might not know. God know. And we said, oh, don't nobody know what I'm doing. I go to church and I say like it ain't nothing, this and that. And God said, yeah, you think nobody know. Ain't your voice getting a little cracky? Lord, him must. I wish he had a little button on that I could shoot it out of there somewhere. Maybe he'll give me one next time. Anybody want me to come and probe? You know what them police do? They do it. And they're good. They say, you know, you had that twang, and they go off. They know you got some. Huh? What's that here? You need to be programmed? Huh? That last don't went away now. I need, you got something going on? Huh? It ain't right what you're doing? Why you doing it then? Huh? You doing something that ain't right? Come on, baby, get up there. You know what you need to do. But see, y'all grown up want to tell on yourself. That's when you want to be right. That's why he said, come as humble as a child. He said, suffer the children not to come to me. He know. Now, if he know he doing wrong, he don't broke down and start crying. Some of y'all will sit right here and look stiff-necked and rebellious and ain't going to say nothing, ain't going to do nothing. Cause why? Child, that's you. I'm 3x7. You ain't doing no legal to go to the real jailhouse. That's what you legal for. You ain't legal for nothing else. I'm legal to get a husband. I'm legal to get a wife. Yeah, you legal for a lot of things. These grown up ain't going to move. They going to try to repent. They gonna try to pin in their seat, you know. That, you know how we do it. Well, you know, Apostle, I understand, but shoot, Apostle, but I told you, I know what God told me. Right now, sent me that ticket and said, "Boy, you better talk. You better keep preaching, man." He said, "Them cracks, them enemy all everywhere, and we keep seeing it." But I wouldn't sit down and know I'm in sin. But some of y'all just that high, that stop on it. I believe some of y'all got a reprobated mind. Because ain't no way you'll know you wrong and sit there and know you in sin, know you ain't living right, and don't repent. Don't tell God nothing. But see, when you got that reprobated mind, you sit there talking about, I don't care what they say. This my life. Okay. You ain't being bigger than me because I'm going to heaven. Shoot, you going to be down there cooking. He said, Proverbs 29 and 27 said, and unto the an unjust man is abomination to the just, and he that is upright is abomination to the wicked. I'm an abomination to a wicked man. I love it too. I used to play ball. I used to want to do them, Joker boy. I ain't playing ball no more. I'm trying to be a tenor for the faith. He said, the word of God is quick and powerful than a two-edged sword, piercing even the asunder, dividing the soul and the spirit, in a joint and a manner, and a discerner of the thoughts and the intents of your heart. Now you tell me the word of God ain't bad. He deal with the thoughts and the intents of your heart. He said, that's rough. He said, when you tell me that God's word can deal with the thoughts and the intents of your heart, and ain't nobody told me nothing, and God don't send the word, I asked Ella, why did God send this word again, man? This about 5, 6 o'clock in the morning. Then Ronell called me and said, Pastor, God told me to tell you, you got to keep preaching. You got to get in the cracks. You got to get in all them places. You can't let nobody sit in there and don't get in there and don't preach that word like you preach it. Now I said, you write that down, because I want to remember that God had gave me this message. And then he told me, he sent me a text and said, you and the word of God is like a proven instrument. That man did not know what I was preaching. He did not even know what was going on with me. But most time I tell Ella, I said, let me tell you what my message is. Ella tell me, I don't want to know. Amen. See, I just want to wait. But he didn't tell me the time. So I got a chance to tell him what I was preaching. Then Ronell sent me a text at 2:18 and told me, you got to go in the crack. You got to get in the places where people don't want you at. He said, you got to probe into their business. And we keep getting this word in him, and we keep taking it lightly, and don't know when we'll die. That would scare me about y'all. It'd be something we would get some watered down message, getting something to play with. But every time you come in, don't you hear a good word? And we sit in here all the time and leave here and still want to do what we want to do. We ought to be saying, God, I'm tired of going against your word. I'm tired of going against what you want. I'm tired. Keep probing and keep telling me the truth, but I'm tired. Lord, I surrender. But I surrender all. See, if you guys ain't going to surrender all to God, ain't no use to surrender. God, I surrender all to you. Now you know all my failure, you know all my shortcomings. Help me, Lord. See, we don't want to beg. My wife preached a message one time. We don't want to cry to the Lord and tell the Lord, Lord, I can't do this. I can't get rid of it. I tried. I can't get. Help me, Lord. We don't want to cry. I tell God all the time, anoint me fresh. Keep me bold. Keep me bold enough to tell your truth. Don't let me beg for money. Don't let me do that. Let me get people saved. If I could just get all of saved and all of going to heaven, I'm going to be a happy man up in heaven. All y'all that don't get to go to heaven. In Isaiah, it said we're going to be able to look over in the carcass and see you down there burning in hell. Do you know what that's going to be? If I can look over in hell and see TC, and I'm going to say, dawg. But I ain't going to have no sympathy or no sorrow, because I'm going to have my glorified body then. It's just going to be him. I'm going to be able to know him. He's going to be able to know me. Ain't that something to be conscious and burning in fire and never fire, never go out, worms eating on you, and then you in different departments in hell and ain't no way to get out. The world might be good now, but how long would it be good? How long? How long? You can certainly hold your breath and live in sin, but for how long? Hell and destruction.